for me is the most positive and the most optimistic Whitesnake album, and it is certainly the first Whitesnake group album, whereas everybody is working together as a team and nobody is trying to stab people in the back.
Rockbox was a hard rock program that was broadcast on Sweden's national radio P3 between 1984 and 1989, featuring Per Fontander as the host. Rockbox covered both the Swedish and international hard rock scene, and in addition to new music, the program also contained interviews with various artists and groups, as well as information about upcoming concerts, etc. In the short showtime of just 45 minutes weekly, Fontander managed to put together a good mix of new and old hard rock, interspersed with investigative journalism in the form of slightly more in-depth interviews, which did not only contain the most obvious of questions. The following interview with David Coverdale was broadcast in 1989.
För ett par veckor sedan firade alla Whitesnake-älskare en något för tidig julafton. Det var ju då nya LP:n Slip of the Tongue rensades ut i skiv. Inte rensade, men rasslade ut till skivbutikerna. Han sprang fram till skivspelet i micken här, så blev lite usch. Men som vanligt då, så har det tagit då ganska lång tid mellan förra LP:n 1987, så den här nya då, närmare bestämt 2 år och 8 månader. Men okej, nu är den i alla fall här, nya LP:n, och naturligtvis har jag då ringt till Mr. Whitesnake själv, David Coverdale, som berättar så här om nya LP:n Slip of the Tongue.
For me is the most positive and the most optimistic Whitesnake album, and it is certainly the first Whitesnake group album, whereas everybody is working together as a team and nobody is trying to stab people in the back. So it is a very, very healthy and very promising time in the history of Whitesnake. I've had good news today.
The
LP in the second week in America is number 13 with a bullet.
Congratulations.
Thank you very much. I'm very, very happy.
David, to me the new songs aren't as direct as the songs on 1987. Do you agree?
Well, there's a lot of musical information, Pa. It is not an immediate album, but some of the songs take a little bit more than one or two listenings to understand. There's a lot of musical information there. But Whitesnake has always been a rhythm and blues hard rock band, and hopefully we learn how to finesse Whitesnake as we go along.
In what way have you been writing the songs this time?
I wrote the songs with Adrian Vandenberg. It was the most powerful and creative exchange I've ever had. He is a true partner and a true friend, and it was an absolutely precious time for me. It is the first time I've really had a true 50-50 partner when I come to writing songs.
Get ready to dance, everybody.
Rock Commander is a celebration of rock and metal culture. Manage your own rock bands, connect with a passionate community, and experience exclusive collaborations with real bands like American Chaos and Adam and the Metal Hawks.
But Adrian Vandenberg is not playing on the album. He was hand injured. What happened to him?
Well, he bought him a piano player's exercise manual. And one of the exercises was supposed to strengthen your wrist, but the exercise stretched the tendons in both of his hands to the point where he couldn't even hold the guitar. So we waited for 6 weeks in the studio while he saw doctors and specialists and Swedish massage. And unfortunately, it was too extreme. So he gave us his trust and his blessing to continue with Steve.
So you called Steve Y instead?
Yeah, well, Steve has been in my mind since I saw a movie called Crossroads many years ago. And the time would not have been right for me to have talked to him then. But for the last 6 months of 1988, I had people doing research into what kind of character he was, if he was happy. And everything I heard was just too good to be true. Mm-hmm. And now I know the man, it was the truth. The guy is a wonderful human being and a master musician. He's a sorcerer.
You really sound great, satisfied, David.
Oh, I've never been so happy. I've never been so happy. If people, I feel as if I could light up this city and melt all the snow in Sweden.
And David, you are still singing about love with a big L. It's your favorite theme, isn't it?
It is the most important. I have my political beliefs and I have my political awareness and my environmental awareness, but my main inspiration has always been the human drama, the physical exchange, the emotional trauma and joy. It's the most fascinating subject I find that motivates me and inspires me to write. They're all taken from my life. They're all kind of lyrical diaries.
True stories, or?
Oh, yes. Only the names are changed to protect the innocent.
So those lyrics are David Coverdale?
Very much so. If somebody reads the lyric very carefully, they can know me very easily. Even the sex. On a good night.
Whitesnake, now you're gone from the help and slip of the tongue. Som rent budskapsmässigt är den absolut mest positiva platta som Whitesnake hittills har gjort. Ja, det berättade som ni hörde, du var mycket uppåt och glad, David Coverdale. Du har ringde honom här i veckan. Och alla de nya låtarna, de är skrivna av det nya Whitesnake-låtskrivarparet, nämligen David själv och så gitarristen Adrian Vandenberg, som på grund av handledsskador tyvärr inte kunde vara med då de spelade in den här plattan. Och det var så här dråpligt att Adrian då, han tyckte att han före skivinspelningen borde träna upp vigheten i handlederna och fingrarna. Så han, ja, vad gjorde han då? Jo, han köpte ett träningsprogram av en pianist. Och den här underkuren då, den gjorde istället att Adrian för tillfället gick under som gitarrist. Han fick sträckningar i varenda handmuskel så han kunde inte ens hålla gitarren. Och det var alltså då som David ringde till Steve Vai som kom och räddade då det sjunkande skeppet i studion. Och sen dess är alltså då både Adrian och Steve, de är fasta bandmedlemmar i Whitesnake. Och precis som på förra LP, 1987, så har då David även den här gången tagit med gammalt material, nämligen den gamla hitten Fool for Your Loving, ursprungligen på LP Ready and Willing som kom 80. Och då är ju naturligtvis frågan, varför gör de nyinspelningar av gamla Whitesnake-låtar?
Well, if it was up to me with my new colleagues, I would re-record every Whitesnake song. Because they are the first time I've ever worked with people who are as passionate about their work and is dedicated as myself. You see, the thing is, I'm more ruthless on myself than ever I've been on other people. And it is a pleasure now to work with such a team of professional and good people.
Yeah, you've got a complete new lineup. What made you change every member from the 1987 lineup?
Well, this is mostly the group from the touring group that supported the 87 album. Before the 87 album, it was more or less session things because there was not a healthy atmosphere within the relationship between all of the musicians. Each musician was there for his own device and not for the group. And everybody wanted a piece of a pie that was not baked.
Yeah,
and it is my choice to work with people who do not try to compromise the concept of Whitesnake. Whitesnake has always been a vehicle for good rock and roll songs. But I sincerely hope that we keep our common sense together and keep this group together because it's too good. It is too good to let go.
Anyway, let's talk about your new lineup, all familiar names. So why don't you introduce them to us? The
you
today's
got it. Okay.
Whitesnake.
Ladies and gentlemen, the sound of trumpets. In the blue corner, Adrian Vandenberg on guitar. In the red corner, Steve Vai on guitar. Rudy Sarzo on bass. Tommy Aldridge on drums. And Sven Svensson on vocals.
Great, David.
Thank you.
The title and the title track on the new album is called Slip of the Tongue. What's the story behind that lyrics?
That is a different angle of looking at things. Usually in hard rock, the man is always the predator, you know, the big cheese. But this time, in Slip of the Tongue, the woman is the dominatrix. She's the power. The man is the slave. And those things do happen.
Du hörde titelspåret på Whitesnakes nya LP, Slip of the Tongue, som handlar om ett förhållande där kvinnan är den mest dominanta parten istället för mannen som är gamla vanliga. Och det berättade David Cavendish, som också förklarade varför de gör nyinspelningar av gamla Whitesnake-låtar. Jo, det är nämligen så här att David tycker att de musiker som han har haft de senaste åren är de absolut bästa och mest intresserade som han någonsin har haft. Så han vill helt enkelt ge de gamla nya låtarna en ny chans att bli riktigt bra. Och förresten, en stor turné är på gång om man räknar att komma till Sverige någon gång om cirka ett år.